Hey everybody, Nathan Foulkes here. So we live in exciting times, right? Yikes. It is, times change, and it seems to be part learning to roll with the punches and part learning how to punch back. So first, if you'll allow me to do my thing, my goal for myself and for all of us is to have as much individual power and as ability as possible. I've worked very hard on my online resources to help by offering my 25 years of navigating my way through the major studios of the animation and the video game industry. And no matter what tools we use or how we end up using them, color and light design for storytelling will always be a critical skill. And we're picture makers. And as we create our own meaningful pictures, the ability to take all the crazy stuff that our images have to be filled with, and having the very difficult ability to put those together with a great sense of purpose, well, that's something that we've got to use and something I've put a great deal of focus on in online resources for you. Check them out. Self-study at your own pace, schoolism.com. Okay, wow, so let me get right to it. In regards to AI, I've promised a partial solution. Now, I can't give specific details yet, but I've been in contact with a technological group that has a solution to protect individual artists from their work being appropriated. They have a cloaking technology that's easily applied to our images, a quick and easy technology that we can apply to anything that we post online that blocks or disrupts AI from seeing and understanding what the image is. You have a specific style and you want to keep that unique to you. You don't want people to type in a direct link to your image and have the AI make something very similar to it. We can protect you and the solution will be free of charge. But Nathan, that's great for newbies, but how about established artists whose work, frankly, is spread all over the internet and cannot be retracted? Yes, that is a very tough one. There is a solution for that also, but the nature of it will require some ethical thought. So they hope to put this out in beta very early in the new year, 2023. Let all of us get involved, give our feedback, fine-tune the process, protect our own work from AI, and continue to work on finding our place as artists in this new and drastically changing world. And for me, I'll continue looking into the idea to develop as much value in our artwork as possible, to use technological means to make it unavailable to be used by anyone who we don't choose to have it be used by, without having to rely on very slow adapting organizations and bureaucracies to do it for us. And if the artwork, the style of it, does indeed have enough juice, then we would have the power position to work with these companies, to partner with them, sell them the right to use our images, if we choose to do that, for a fee, for a profit, for a royalty. And some of you out there who are so incredibly stunning and popular in the allure and appeal of the artwork that you've created, some of you, I see huge signing bonuses and huge opportunity. So doom and gloom? I don't think so. But I suspect that we all also have the feeling that when things go terribly, terribly wrong, as they always do at points in life, you know, the depth and the richness of life is digging in and finding the meaningful ways to turn it around, to use it, to expand the bubble of our capabilities and our life experience. And I'll tell you, I have a lot of excitement about this, even though I do feel a bit guilty for my enthusiasm, because I'm very aware of the struggle that the new artists in the learning curve are going through in the current environment. And for those of you early in the learning curve, your artwork is not yet spread all over the internet. As you post it, you can protect it. And as you get better, your juice, your negotiating power, and the use of your artwork approved by you get stronger. So I actually envy you beginners out there. There's a good chance that you'll never have to worry about having to reach into the far corners of the internet and try and retract artwork that's been posted without any protection, that can be appropriated by some people in some places where legislation can never reach. Potentially, you hold all of the control. That's what I'm fighting for. So as always, very best wishes for me. I wish you all the most success.